Yeah, here I am. This poker_neo is my new file, which has only the basic code, the functions, the first day version that is present in this. Yes? Okay. Based upon the test cases given to us, how many rules we have to implement in this particular version, complete version of poker? We have poker game, right? From this, how many rules were asked to implement? Yeah?
Five of a kind of pawn.
Where is five of a kind royal? Huh? Except royal flush, straight flush is there. Royal flush, okay, I think it's not given. Okay?
Wikipedia.
Okay, we'll see in the order, okay? In the reducing order, straight flush. Okay, once we'll go to Wikipedia and see. Yes,
five of a kind
is similar to royal flush. Huh? Okay, right. Ignore five of a kind is not given for us. Ignore that. Straight flush is first. That means these are the priority orders. The top ones has the highest priority. That means they will have the highest score. Okay. Now first, straight flush, four of a kind, full house, flush, straight, three of a kind, two pair, one pair, high card. All these nine conditions are being implemented right for us in this particular version 3, the complete poker game. Right. When we come to poker_new.py file, poker file, we'll come across the basic functions of is straight, is flush, yes, and hand_rank, and we have poker, the where we need to play the game. When we come to the main game from when we come to main function, where am I going from main function? Yeah, poker. Okay, I'm going to poker. Yeah, poker has one argument, hands. Okay, what does this hands hold? List of hands. Okay, we'll open one of the test case and we'll see. Yes, from here we can see first we have integer 4 and we have 4 rows. As we see in the code, we have count is given. Based on the count, those many number of times it will ask for input, and as n equal to 4, and there are 4 rows. That means each row represents one hand. You all have seen this previously itself. Now from here I'll come to poker game. In poker game, what I will do? This whole function of poker game is done, right? Only this particular return statement will perform all the operations that has to be satisfied by poker function, right? Now what happens? We'll be passing list of hands and a poker function. For every list, poker hand_rank function will be executed. Yes, based upon our requirement above, we are returning a value based upon which rule that particular hand is satisfying, whether a straight or a flush, right? All this. Now from here, where should I go? Hand_rank, right? Okay, I came here. Here what I should do? Give conditions. Yes. If I see here, what are the rules that are present here? Okay, here I can write. What are the rules present in poker game? Straight flush, four of a kind, full house, flush, straight, three of a kind, two pair, one pair, and high card. Yes, we will be writing all these functions to be implemented. That means all these for every hand that we are passing, all these cases should be checked by that particular hand. Okay, right. First, with what I should go? If is straight of hand, and is underscore flush of hand. Okay. If this is satisfied, what should I return? Return. If you see here, we have 1 to 9. Should we go from 9? Straight is 1. High cut is 9. Can we return 9? That means in the descending order. Yes? Return 9. Yes? Next. What is the next rule that I have to check for? Is underscore for of a kind, and I'll be passing hand. Yes, we stop near. What is the next rule that has to be implemented? Is for of a kind. Yes, and for that I'm passing the hand, and what value should I return? Return 8. Yeah, what is the next rule that I should check for a hand? Full house. Is underscore full house of hand. The return value is? Return is 7. Okay. Next rule. If is underscore flush. I'm passing hand as argument. Return value is? 6. Return value is 6. Okay. Next. If next rule is, what is the next rule?
Straight.
Straight and hand. I'm passing. What should I return? Return 5. Okay. If what is the next rule? 3 of a kind. Yes. I should pass hand. What is the return? Return 4. Yes. If what is the next rule? Is 2 pair. I should return. What is the return value? Return 3. Okay. If the next rule is 1 pair and return 2. If not, if is underscore high card. Return 1. At end, I'm returning 0. Okay. These are all my rules, right? Yes. I have 9 rules that every hand has to check. Whichever satisfied, that will be executed. Yes. Now.
I have a question.
Sir.
So there's a high card. When you get a high card, you return 1.
Yes.
What would be less than high card?
High card is the least. For us, high card is the least itself. But just we are written.
Is there something lower than high card? No, right. So you don't need zero. And how do we check if it's a high card? So if it's none of those, then it's a high card.
Yes. Okay. Right. Yes, we have all these rules. Now, what is the function that we first executed? Is straight. We'll go to is straight function. Is straight. Okay. What is he asking us to do? How do you find out if the given hand is a straight? The hand has a list of cards representing a string. You know, yes, each row is a hand. There are multiple ways of checking if the hand is straight. Do we need both the characters in a string? What do you all say? Yes or no? Okay. We'll highlight this. Okay, we'll think about it again. The first character is good enough. He's saying the first character is good enough, right? Only two. Because how do you say whether a hand is straight or not? The face values of cards should be in a sequence. Yes? Then think of the algorithm. Okay. As he told, do we need both the face and the suit? We only need face values. Yes? Okay. Right here. How do I get face values? For C, comma, S. In. Hand. Yeah. Okay. What should we name it? Yes. MTLS. Now. Dot append C. Okay, done. Now what should I do? You have to check whether they are in a sequence or not. Okay, how do you check it? S is equal to set of face underscore values. Okay, what is set function performing here? It removes the duplicate. That means it duplicate values will not be added to the set. Yes? Okay. Now what should we perform? Okay. Right. What kind of values we can have for each card? From 2 to 9, 10, J, 10 is represented as T here, J, Q, K and A. Yes? Then how do you convert T, J, Q, K and A to integers? Yeah? Using dictionary. Okay, what is, one way what she is saying is we can use a dictionary. Is there any other way that we can use?
String.
Okay. How you perform using string?
First two characters you leave it blank, so then you start with two.
Okay. Then we start from?
Two till
nine. T, J. Q, K and A. Yes? Now what I'll do? What we should do?
Use index for index functions.
Dot index of C. Yes? What is happening here?
Index number of C.
Which index? Okay, for example, if my C is 9, what will be the value that this particular expression will be, statement will be returning?
9
itself. Because this index function will check at which index this C value is present. Understood, Madhavi? Okay, this is 0, 1, 2. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yes? It's returning the index value of 9. Then you'll get 9 itself. Yes, that's how you can convert T to 10, J to 11, Q 12, K13 and A14. That's how we are converting our strings to integers. Yes? Yeah, next, what should we perform?
Set of face values.
Yes, we have seted it. If there are any duplicates, this set function will remove them. Yes. Now, next step. If
length of
face underscore set equal to equal to 5 and
max
of face underscore set minus min of face underscore set
equal to
one second will come again. Okay, right, that is one condition. Okay, your example is if A 2 3 4 5 is given. Okay, the another condition is if 4 5 6 7 8 are given, we need to check. Okay, first we'll see for 4 5 6 7 8. We'll write a condition for 4 5 6 7 8, then we'll go. First we'll satisfy one of them. What you want to satisfy first? 4 5 6 7 8? Yes? Okay. Then what should this statement be? Is equal to 4. Okay. For this case also, by making what changes, does maximum minus minimum will return 4? If you convert A to 1, we can say that 5 minus 1 is also 4, right? Then that case will also be satisfied. Yes? In that case, can we say if face set equal to, okay, okay, before this, how will the values get stored? Will they be in the sequence? Okay, can we sort it? Yes? Yeah?
Set and automatic increasing order.
Will sort the list? No, it will not. If we perform this, will the set be in the sorted order right now? Yes or no? What does this sorted function perform? It just returns a sorted list. Whatever argument that I am passing, it just sorts it and returns it. Yes? Now a sorted list is stored in set, right? That means set is in sorted order. For example, our values are, okay, what will be the value of A?
2, 3, 4, 5, 14.
14. These will be your values, right? 2, 3, 4, 5 and 14. Yes? Can I say 2, 3, 4, 5, 14? If I come across this, I'll say face set equal to
1, 2, 3.
Yes. Can I say this? Yes. Now I converted my A 14 value to 1. So in this case, 5 minus 1, what will be the value? 4. Then this case is satisfied, right? Yes. Yes or no? Okay. In that case, okay, we executed our isRate function. Should we check it? Whether it's working fine or not? Okay, what else we have to write to check whether isRate function is working correctly or not? Yeah? What should be written?
Statement computed.
Okay, now? Return?
True.
Should we write else also? Not required. Okay. Is there a way where I can remove this if condition also? Can I say return of, does this statement work? It works, right? If the condition is satisfied, if length of the set is 5 as well as maximum minus minimum is equal to 4, it returns a true. If one of the condition fails, it returns a false. Yes, okay. Right. Should we check isRate right now? Whether it's working fine or not? Okay. We executed here. Before that, I'll check from here. isRate of hand. Print. Okay. Yes, Shishan. No.
Last function is only type of the A2345, A K2J, T raste.
Okay, which test case do you want me to give?
A2345 A K Q J T.
A2345
A K Q J T.
One second. A K
Q J
Q J T. Then you, okay, then in that case, I'll not modify my face set, right? My values will be 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. I did not get you.
Max and a function, you run the hands will apply right there. Run it after one, return this value of the straight law, 6 is number error, run it to the
So there are two hands.
Okay.
Both the hands are straight.
Yes.
One is a bigger straight, one the other is a smaller straight.
Yes.
So, how do you break the tie?
How do you break the tie? In that case, for that...
That's your question.
I'll be writing some other function where I'll calculate the face values and I'll return a value for that. For example, okay, here I have.
Do you need a short answer or a long answer? I have a 1 second answer, here's a 1 minute answer.
Yes.
So, let's say you have two straights, right? Two straights are on the table. How do we break it? Who would get it?
High card.
High card. So, you have to pass the high card also to max.
Right?
Right.
We'll be picking only one card.
We can pick all in a sorted order. Directly you can write the max of one list, which is say 1, 2, 3. 5-4-3-2-1. That's one case. The second one, which is, what is the second one? 14-13.
Yes, sir.
14-13, 12-11. So this is the representation we need to set for max, right? Now, if you get a straight flush, what is the rank you're passing? 8?
8.
You're passing. Also have 8 in the table. Yeah. 8, comma, 2, 3.
8?
Yeah, 8. I think you have an extra list. And now, before 8, you have to open a square bracket. Close. And 8 again for the second. The second list also needs a...
So... Yes.
Does that representation make sense to you? So what we are capturing is 8 indicates the string, and the values after that are all the ranks in the sorted order, right? So now you pass that to max. What will max do?
It will return the first part.
It will return the second argument as well. There are two lists passed through. So what it does is, first checks 8 and 8. Max will check 8 and 8. Both are equal. Then it will go to the next element. The next element is 5 in one case, the next element is 14 in the other case. So 14 plus 1.
But sir, we are not passing, in that case, we are passing only 8s to the max, not the entire list. Other list.
Currently you are doing that. Now you need to modify your code to add the other stuff and send it to max. Make sense? The short answer to formulate. But we'll discuss that again.
Okay. Where we are?
Sorry.
Yeah, is straight. In that case, straight, I never called from.
So we wanted to test this straight, and then we interrupted saying, what if there are
both?
Times?
Yes.
That's the last one, you know, checkpoint.
Okay.
I'm doing a git commit for your conversation.
Now I'll say Python poker new yes your one yes. Yes, sir. Yes. These are the four rows that have been read. Among them, I am just returning true or false. Check for true or false, whether it is satisfying or not. Check here. At 65th line, I have written print is straight of hand. Every time when I pass a hand, it's taking it, the function is underscore straight is taking the hand and returning whether it is true or not. Yeah. First it told true. Is 2, 3, 5, 6, 4 2, 3, 5, 4, 6 a straight? Yes, okay. 3, 9, 7 T K are they straight? Yes or no? No. Okay, it's false. A 3, 9, 5 Q. Are they straight? No, so it's a false. A K T J Q. True. is straight function is working, right? Yes. Okay. Our is straight is working. Next, what is the function that is present? Is flush. Okay, we'll go to is flush function. Okay, here. Yes. Here also. Okay, what is flush function taking? A hand as an argument. Here, how do we find out if the given hand is a flush? That's the question. The hand has a list of cards represented as string. Do we need both the characters in the string? What do you all say? To find whether a hand is flush or not, do we need both the characters in a string? No. Okay. What do we need? The suit or the face value? We just need the suit. If the suit for all the values is same, then we can say it is a flush. The cards are flush. Sorry, the hand is a flush. Yes? Yeah, what is the logic for this? For C comma S in first empty list. Okay. This is suits. Yes. Okay. Suits in hand. Suits underscore list dot append. Append of?
Yes.
Only yes. Yes. Okay. Right now I got only suits. Now what should be my next statement? Set. Okay. Suits underscore set equal to
set
of suits underscore list. Okay, I got a set. Now, length of
written space length of suits underscore set equal to
return length of suits underscore set equal to 1. Yes, only this statement is enough? Yes? You want to append directly to set? No need of list? Yeah, have you understood what Tulsi has told? He wants us directly to append to set itself. To set, how to add to a set?
Add.
What function should we should be using to add to a set?
Add.
We need to use an add function. Yes, add is the function that helps to add data to a set. Yes, would this be enough?
It's not sure.
You're not sure. Okay, check it out. Yeah. 40 suits underscore set. Okay, right. Suits underscore set. Yes. Would it be enough? Should we test it? Okay. Yeah?
Add
circle with the. Okay. Here I am executing both is straight as well as is flush. Should I execute only one? Should I execute both? Okay, I'll execute only one. Is flush. Okay. Yes. On the same first input file I executed it. The first hand, is it a flush? Are the suits all the same? No. So it's a false. The second suit, sorry, the second hand, no. Okay, it's false. For the third hand, are all the suits same? Yes. That's why it's true. That means it's working fine. The fourth hand for it, it is true. So your suit is working fine. Sorry, your flush is also working correct, right? Yes. Okay. In this case, right. Now my is straight is working, is flush is also working. What is the next function that I am coming across here? Is four of a kind. Okay, do I have this function here right now? No, right? So I should be writing it. Def. What is the argument it takes? Hand. Okay. How should I implement this? Okay. For each string, what data is required for me to solve it? Only that would be fine. Is what you all say? It should work. Yes? Yeah, what others say? What actually is the rule of four of a kind? What is the rule saying here? Are you all able to watch this? Yes, four of a kind. What is it saying? At least four cards should be having the same face value. Yes, then we can say that particular hand is a four of a kind hand. Yes, how I should solve it? Okay, what would be the first statement that I should be writing? Face value is equal to empty list. Yeah, what should we be writing?
Set is not a good handle for everything.
For C comma
S in
hand. Okay. Then face values equal to, sorry, dot append of C or S?
C.
Okay. Yes.
I have another question. If you are going to power, do we need to take another list? No. Don't need to. So you can actually go over the list and then directly use face. You won't even use face value. What you say is hand is the list. So hand dot count of C.
Hand dot count of C. Yes.
అది మళ్ళీ ప్రెగ్నెన్సీ అన్నది చేస్తాను అప్పుడు పన్ను లోపల ఒక ఇంటి రాస్తే
what would it be enough? Yeah. Here what is happening, I'm iterating through each element in a list. For example, if this is the list, 2D is my first element, 2 is C and S is D. Now I'm checking if 2 is, 2's count is in which this complete list is 4 or not. If it is true, then I'll go to if condition and I'll return true. Like that I'll be performing it, 4 of a kind. If here for the first list, does 4 of a kind work for any of the 4 hands? No. Then will it go into the if condition at all? Yes. It's wrong. So, that means it's not satisfying the 4 of a kind condition. So it will not go in. And at the end we'll be returning false. Then in that case, this does this function satisfy our requirement? Can we say that or no? Positive scenario. Okay. Can we take... Yeah, okay. Yes, sir. Is 4 of a kind? One second. Python. Okay. PY. One. Yeah. 7C. Yes, would it be enough? The example? Yeah. False. It's written false.
Thank you. a bug there. I introduced the bug at 947. Can someone catch it?
What does hand have? What is list of? You are checking 7 with 7 C, 7 H, 7 D.
Yeah, so the counter will be 0 because we are always checking it with the face value. What is the value of C D? 7.
The face value.
It will only be the face value, right? It will only be the number. Whereas the list has the number and also the string.
I did not get it. Face? Okay, we are not appending it anywhere. So we have to first append to it. Okay, you want me to append to it? Yeah? Dot? Append? C. Okay. If now in face
underscore
values count of face. If it's a true, equal to 4, return true. Yes, should be executed. Yes, it's working. Is it working or not? Yes. Okay. Is 4 of a kind is satisfied? Okay, here from the previous functions, what are the repetitive things that we have done? We are getting the face values regularly, right? Why? Which function? Okay, if that means this is underscore 4 of a kind function. From here, which function I should call? Is underscore string or is underscore flush? Yes, that means we need to write a separate function for this. Okay, why don't you think like this? Why can't we write a separate function for this? Yes. Def. Hand. And. Yes. Here, what should I return? Should I sort or not? It's not required. Face values. Yeah. Should I sort and send? Sorted off. Okay, sorted and sending it. Okay, where have we used it? We have used it here, right?
No, sir. Again, we have to, in case of tiebreaker, we need to put
it. Yeah. Yes, one second. Can I replace this complete code with this function? Yes. Okay. Get values of hand. I'll get a sorted list. And there is another function also where we have used it, right? Here, did we perform it? Okay, why can't we implement this also there? Every time we are accessing face values, they should be converted from A, T, J to integers, right? Why can't we implement this option there also? Yes, we'll copy this and okay, right here index string dot index of C. Yeah, will this return my requirement? Yes. Here also, can I remove everything of this and just call that particular function? Yes. Get only face values of hand. Yes. Okay. Here is underscore 4 of a kind is done. Yes. Now what is the next function? This function is tested. What is the next function here?
Full house.
Full house. Yes. Okay. We don't have a full house, so we need to write a full house function. Def full house of hand. Next, what I should be doing here? How does full house work? Why can't? Okay, how do you say like, sir? Okay, if I have four of one. Okay. Yeah, are you all able to go with him? Yes or no? No or yes? Should we just check the set size and conclude that the house is a full house? The hand is a full house. Okay. Yeah, Tulsi, tell your code. How you want me to write? First, get only the face values, okay?
Set off. Get underscore only face values of
hand. Face values of
hand.
Yes, next.
If length equal.
If. This everything you want to write in? One statement, okay.
Return
length of
equal to 2, double equal to
2. If length equal to 2,
it is true.
It is true, that's it. Okay. Should we test this particular function? Full house of hand. Yes. Yeah, what should be my inputs? Seven D, 2D, 2D. Yes. It is satisfying our requirement, right? This full house logic is helping us in doing so. Yes? Okay.
Well, it only works if you have
only one in it.
only work if you have four of the kind of records. The precondition for full flowers is...
Yes, sir. As four of the kind, rank is higher than two by two.
Yes.
So it stands to...
Only in that case it works. Otherwise it doesn't. Right?
Yes.
So if I want to isolate full flowers and check for full flowers,
does it
only for full flowers, it will still say a true for four of the time. Right? That's the point I'm making. So it's very tightly connected to your hand rank function, where you need four of the kind before that function and then full of the time. So what do you have for that?
Yeah, okay. His fullows function is working, right? Yes. Without sequence, huh? Okay. Yeah, give your inputs. Okay. Okay, whatever it might be.
Then it fails. New poker system where full house is higher than four of a kind.
It works.
Then this will fail. That's the point. You want to test that?
It will fail.
It will fail.
We can say, okay, if you want to still check, we can. Okay. Print off.
We know why it will fail. They know it will fail. They know why it will fail. Should we do it similar to four of a kind? Like check for three of a kind and two of a kind.
Yes.
And then you have three of a kind, two of a kind also will be answered.
You can add one more condition. If count is not equal to four, and then you can go to further if count is equal to four.
If count is not equal to four and set that equal to
and then you can return how many times. There's a different way in which you can actually structure all these functions. Because you're already, you know, immersed into this, it may be a good idea to think about it this way. You have two of the kind, you have three of the kind, you have four of the kind that you
two nulls where we are checking for three of the kind and two of the kind. Right? Why can't we generalize all of this and make only one function called kind and pass the and, or pass the line, not even kind, comma. If you want to check for three of the kind, pass three. If you want to check four of the kind, pass four. If you want to check for two of the kind, pass two. Which means the same function will hold good for all three of them. Make sense? Yeah. It's similar to what you said, except you wanted to return the number of times it is occurring. I'm saying you know that you want a particular fact to repeat for that many times. You pass it as an argument and then check if it is. If you are looking for four of a kind, pass four to the function as a function. If you are looking for three of a kind, pass three as the function. And if you are looking for two of a kind, pass two as a function. So that way this one function solves. Because again you have the same code template. The same loop has to be there, the same dot count has to be there. So one function does the job. Is everyone on board with that? No? Yeah. Maybe if we implement the email. Krishna.
Shishank.
Does that make sense? I don't know about others. They're very quiet. I have to call and ask. These people are quiet today. These many people are quiet.
I think, sir, we'll be continuing this later. After completion of everything, we'll organize it.
Okay.
Would that be? Because you might get confused.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Okay. Yeah, okay. Similar to four of a kind, if you have to do, what we have to do here? Is full. This is written, but I need to check whether full house is three in five cards. I should have three of one kind, two of another kind. I need to check that also. Then how should I implement it? Can I say face value is equal to? Yes, we can perform that. Later we'll organize that way. First we'll complete this. Yes. If length of 2 equal to 2, then only I'll go inside. If not, by default I'll return false. Okay. Here what I should check for? What should I be checking for? For example, my list has, okay, now I'm getting only face values. These are my face values. 3 comma 3 comma 3 comma 5 comma 5. Yes? Okay. I'll say A equal to so and so. A equal to this. If I say A dot count of A of 0, what will it return? 3. Okay. If I say, okay. length of A minus 1, what will it return? Think that this is my hand. Yes? For condition of full house, what should I perform? What are the rules? I should have only two kinds of face values. One should be of 3, one should be of 2. Yes, we already sorted. When we call this function, it is returning a sorted list to us, right? Yes. Here, if we say, if face values dot count of A of 0. Okay. We'll remove the set. Okay, we cannot perform that again, right? Okay. Then how we should be doing it? Should we convert it again to list? Should we convert the set to list again? Okay, have you understood what I have implemented here? Yes, that's what. But here to check this condition, can you perform this operation without this set? Can you see that? Knowing of this, this also, this is not required at all. Okay, we'll ignore this. Yeah, tell your condition. These two, okay. Face values of, if face values of dot count of face values of 0 equal to 3 and here
4.
Okay, why to take a chance? Length of minus 1. Yes, this should be 2. Okay, here there might be a case where it might be vice versa, right? You have only 3 2s and 3 5s. A situation will understand. Yes, then or can we say this? Yes. Yeah. Have you all understood this particular statement? What this is saying? Yeah, Kranti. Oh. Okay, Ardhamain Nantin. Yes. Others? Okay, here what should be my next statement? Return? True. If not return, false. Would it be enough? Yes. Okay. Give your inputs. 1. It's working, right? Yes. Should we provide with another test case where 4D, 4D, 6C, 6C, 6C?
No idea.
Yeah? Sorry. 1, 4d, 4d, 6c, 6c, 6c. It's working for this case also. Yes? Is your, okay, our condition is satisfied, right? Based upon the full house here. Yes? Okay, what is the next function that we have to implement? Full house is done, is flush. Is flush is also already done, right? Is flush is already done, okay. Next after that? Is straight. Is straight is also already done, okay. Is 3 of a kind, okay. Here we'll come across this. Def of hand. Now what should I do? How can I say whether a hand is 3 of a kind or not? If? Okay. But they all don't want to go with that, only that particular condition. There might be a case where it fails. Yes, what is the other solution? Any one of the rows should be? Okay. Do you all want to go with her like set? We should be using a set. Okay, I'll be writing in face underscore set equal to get set of if length of face underscore set equal to 3. Inside they want to do it. Okay, now yes. Okay, in your case what you are saying is it will have 3, 3, 4, 5. Yes? 0, 1, 2, 3, but what happens to if A equal to 3, 4, 4, 4 and 5?
0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Once again, come on.
0, 1, 2.
Okay, you don't want to do iteration for all those. You want to go with 1 or 2. That is first 3 elements. Okay. Each underscore face in face underscore list. If face underscore list dot count of each underscore face equal to 3, else I just return true. If I find it in the first one itself, it will return off. Yes? If it finds in the second one, it returns at the second. If it is at the third, it will return third. If it is not returning, then it is failing. In that case, I should return a false. Yes, would it be enough? Here you need to check, you have 5 elements in a hand, 5 cards in a hand. you need to check if three hands are having the same face value. Yes? That means only three are required. Other two will be of different kind. Here I am checking length of set of face set. Face list. Here I am getting all the face values as a list. I am converting it to list and checking the length. If the hand has three cards with the same face value, only one element will be there in the set and other two of two different values. Now its length will be 3. Yes? Then in that case it can satisfy a condition, right? One of the conditions. We can say it is 3 of a kind. After completion of that, again I am coming inside. I am checking it for each element. For example, here I have first three elements in the first, okay, three elements of same kind in the first itself. In the other case, I have at the middle. What this helps me is to iterate through each element and find the count of that particular element in the particular complete list. Understood? If not, we can again go through it. Here we have this A. I printed A. A dot count of 4. Yes. If I say my count of 3 is also 3. Similar to this, I am using this operation here. Face underscore list dot count of each underscore face equal to 3. If it is equal to 3, I am going inside and I am just returning true. In that case, it satisfies our requirement, right? Yes. Now should we test, is 3 of a kind? Is is 3 of a kind and what is the function? I need to give one input. 3D, 5D, 6D. It's returning true. Now is 3 of a kind function being implemented? Last 3 you want to give on the test case? Okay. 1. 2D, 3D, 4D, 4D. 4D. Yes? Either way it's working. Yes? Now 3 of a kind is also working. What is the next thing? Is 2 pair. You need to check a 2 pair. Okay, I'll write here. Def is 2 pair of hand. Next, can I copy this everything of this code and say 2 of a kind means this set size becomes 4, right?
3.
Okay, this also becomes 3. Yes, but here it should be true 2. Yes. Two. Okay, other input you want to check. Once again, 2 pair, that is a function, right? Yes, in this 2 pair, that means 2 cards should be of the same kind or 2 pairs should be of 2 kind? 2 pairs should be of same kind. In that case, okay, that means we can cannot return at the first stage itself. ఓకే యాక్చువల్ టు సే లేటర్ ఆన్ వీ హ్యావ్ మోర్ ఆర్గనైజ్డ్ దిస్ ఫర్ యూ టు మీకు అర్థం అవ్వాలని ఇలా చెప్పుకుంటూ వెళ్తున్నాను. తర్వాత ఇంకా ఆర్గనైజ్ ఇవన్నీ ఆల్మోస్ట్ 3 or 4 ఫంక్షన్స్లో అయిపోతాయి మొత్తం. సేమ్ ఇదే లిస్ట్ ఇదే ప్రాసెస్ చేసుకుంటూ వెళ్తే 4 or 5 ఫంక్షన్స్ మ్యాక్సిమం, దానికన్నా ఎక్కువ లేవు. అలా ఇది ఇప్పుడు మీకు అర్థం అవడానికి ఇలా చెప్పుకుంటూ వెళ్తున్నాను కాన్సెప్ట్. ఫస్ట్ రాసిన తర్వాత దీన్ని ఆప్టిమైజ్ చేసుకోవచ్చు, ప్రాబ్లం లేదు. ఎస్ ఎక్కడ ఓకే వాట్ యు వాంట్ టు డూ విత్ జే? Yeah, what do you all guys say? Madhavi has told a condition where she wants to count how many number of how many types of face values which have of same kind, which are of same kind. That means, for example, if I have A equal to two comma three comma three comma five, she want to count how many number of pairs are there of two size. Should we go with that logic or is there any other logic to find out? Second, here we have face I'll say set of face and score list. Here I'll get only unique values, right? Though they are duplicates. Yes, count count equal to 0, I'll say first initially. If this condition is satisfied, I'll say count plus equal to 1. Here, if count equal to 2, I'll say return true. If not, it will return false automatically. Would it satisfy your requirement? Is this particular logic satisfying your requirement? What does set of face and score list do? It removes all the duplicates. Yes? If you give 2, 2, 3, 3 and 4, you will have only 2, 3 and 4 in it. Here I am checking if face and score list dot count of 2 equal to 2. In which am I checking it? In face and score list. Not in the set, I am checking in the list. Then if it is satisfying, I am increasing my count. I am going to the next unique element in the set, that is 3. 3's count is also 2. So again I am increasing the count. Yes? Set, I am going to the third unique element in the set. If its count is also 2, then it will increase. If not, it will not. But what condition it has to satisfy? It should have only 2 pairs. Yes? That's what I'm doing there. If count equal to 2, I'm returning true. Yes? Should we test it? Okay. 2D, 2D, 3D, 5D, 5D. Yes? Would this test case be enough? It is returning true. Do you have any problem? No. Okay. Is 2 underscore pair. Now what is the next condition? one pair. Okay. Here, def of hand of what you should be doing? This becomes 4, right? And here you can say okay, sorry, this is 2 itself. Yes, this I need to check. Yes, is this completing your requirement? You can get one of a kind pair, right? Now if I go here, okay, one is one pair, paste it, execute it, 1, 2D, 3D, 4D, 5D, 5D. It's reading through. Is one pair, it is satisfying our requirement? Yes? Okay. That is also done. What is the next one? Is high and score card. Here in this case, def of hand of, now what this should be like?
Return max of Aranta of the
room. Only if this condition is there. Instead of this also, I can optimize it, right? Return okay. What rule satisfies my condition here? High card. What should high card say? Yeah, what should high card say? 5 different cards. It should have 5 different cards. Yes? Now here when I say get underscore only face values of hand, I'll get only the list of face values, right? Now I got it. Now I converted that list to set. Yes? All the duplicates will be removed. And now I'm finding the length of that particular set. Is equal, and I am checking with 5. If it is true, then it will return true. If it is false, it will return false. Yes? Should we test it? Yeah, what should I give? 1D. Okay, sorry. 1D, 2D, 3D. 4D and 5D. What should it return? Does one input work? 2D, 3D, 4D, 5D, 7D. Yes. Check your input. Does they form a is high card satisfy hota ya? Is high card ya cheppandi? Is high card rule satisfy avutunda ikkada? Yeah, for example, if I give another input, if I say 2D, 2D, 3D, 4D and 5D, it is returning false if it doesn't satisfy the condition. Yes? Right? Okay. Now is underscore high is also done. Are there any functions that we have to implement? Is underscore high is also done? What we should be doing then in that case? I am uncommenting all this. I am commenting only this. Yes? Now I am executing eval. Now eval should work fine, right? Every test case has passed properly. Yes?
Time
Huh? Okay, once again, after execution, we'll get to know what there are errors. 18 of the test cases are passed. Yes. How many test cases are passed? 18 of them have been passed. Which test case is failing? అన్ని పాస్ చేస్తున్నారు. నైన్త్ కూడా పాస్ అని చెప్తుందమ్మా. జీరో ఫెయిల్. Yeah, that's what it's saying, right? Yeah, we'll execute once again. 18 of 19 and one, which one is failing? It's not saying. Yeah, which test case will be failing? For you, the ninth one failed. Okay? First test case you want to check. Okay, we'll go for the output once. Okay, this is our output. Python. Python poker less than test cases / input 1. For the first input, you want to know the output. Your output is correct. Should we check for all the outputs? Which output is failing? What is the file name? Okay, 2. 1 second. Okay, right. We'll give second input. Are these both matching? Yes. So second test case is also correct. We'll check the third test case. 2D, 3S, 5S, 4C, 6D. This is also satisfied. Now we'll check the fourth test case. 3D, 6D, 7D, TD, QD. This is also correct. Okay, 1 second. We'll do them. 4C, 7D, TC, 7C, TD. This is also done. Sixth one, 6C, AH, 7S, 7H, 7D. This is also correct. QS, AD, 8QD, 8S, TC. Okay, this is also correct. Next test case, 8th one. 3C, 3D, 3S, 9S, 9D. This is also correct. 9S, 9C, 7D, 9H, 9S. This is also working. Two C, 3S, 8S, 8D, TD. These also worked.
Sir, didn't the input of it?
Huh?
Didn't the input of it? A5.
Which test case? That's 9th test case.
10th.
Okay, sorry, 10th.
Because ఇక్కడ రెండు టూ ఆఫ్ ఎ కైండ్ ఉంటే మనం ఎలా డిస్టింగ్విష్ చేస్తాము? అలా వన్ పేర్ ఉంది రెండు ఫైవ్ ఎయిట్.
వన్ సెకండ్. ఈవెల్ పోకర్ న్యూ కదా. ఇందా మనం ఏ ఫైల్ ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ చేసాం? మన కోడ్ రాసింది పోకర్ అండర్స్కోర్ న్యూలో. ఓకే రైట్, ఇప్పుడు అర్థమైంది. విచ్ టెస్ట్ కేసెస్ ఫెయిల్డ్ from the starting we'll be seeing 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. Okay, we'll write notepad. Test cases are 9. One second. 9 means it's the 10th test case. Next one is 14. 14 means it's the 15th one. 16, 17. Yeah, out of 19, 14 passed. That means 5 failed. 16, 15, 14. 10, 1, 2,
something is wrong with the test case.
Antena? Okay. It's a test case could replace it now. Yeah, test cases folder. Git test, we'll delete the results, we'll replace, no, we'll delete all the test cases and we'll paste them all. Okay, idene paate vache module 15 poker. These are your test cases. CTs, practice, module 15, poker. Excuse me. Yeah, now it should work, right? Eval, poker underscore new dot py. 15 of 19, now it's 15 of 19. That means only 4 test cases are failed. Those are 15, 16, 17 and 10. Okay, these 3 are the test cases that has to be completed. Okay. Should we continue after 5?
Yes, sir.
Yes? Okay.